Wackademia, Harvard donations, Rita.
Yes, this is a mega, mega donor. He has donated hundreds of millions to Harvard over the years. And finally, I would say well overdue, Ken Griffin has said, enough. The joint's just producing these woke idiots. They're not elite any longer, and he doesn't want his money going. But how did it take him this long? Because the decline in Harvard hasn't just come about in the last 6 months. I know the way they reacted to October...
It's been going on for decades.
Decades. Yeah. And they're patently racist with their admissions.
But we need to see this happening in Australia. You've got to start defunding these stupid universities that are churning out all these woke idiots, seriously. If you happen to be, you know, you have this image of your days at university and you think, oh, well, I loved university when I was there, and sending money to these universities, no, they are poisonous, they are dangerous, most of them, not all of them, obviously. James?
Oh, yeah, well, look, I was just going
to say... Tampon dispensers.
Oh, yeah.
Rita and I wanted you to talk about the tampon dispenser.
Yes, sir, very quickly.
You being the man on the panel.
In the great state of Connecticut,
oh.
A high school installed a tampon dispenser in the boys' bathroom, of course, as you do. This piece of equipment lasted a full 20 minutes before the wise young men of this school simply said, no, this is ridiculous, and ripped it off the wall. Now, the principal, of course, had an absolute meltdown over this. He said he was disgusted by this act because apparently it was, you know, all sorts of phobic or whatever. But, you know, I think the boys here had a bit more common sense than the principal.
Well, the principal has got his pronouns listed.
Oh, thank God for that.
Yeah, so, there, I mean, perhaps there is one man who's got his period at that school, and that's the principal.